just want to shoot through a bunch of headlines real quick here. And these will all be linked below so you can read the full articles if you want. Prime Minister admitted to hospital over virus symptoms. And this is Boris Johnson here, Prime Minister of Great Britain. He actually contracted the virus about 10 days ago. He was admitted to the hospital on Sunday, I believe, and they said it was just for precautionary tests and everything like that. So again, it just shows no matter who you are, it can touch you, right? So let's flip to this next one. This is actually something I have been thinking about and talking about in my videos for some time. I wondered how India itself, say India, regions of Africa, even Asia, other areas where there are poorer populations that are really dense, how were they going to deal with it? So here, the race to stop the virus spread in Asia's biggest slum, and this is India they're talking about, of course. More than, look at this photo, more than 650,000 people live in 50 acres of space in Dharavi. Look at this, it's so tightly condensed. Imagine that. Just a couple brief things from this here. It says hundreds of people who attended a religious event in the capital set off several COVID-19 clusters across the country and are now linked to some 650 cases across 14 states. What was it? I think it was about 2 weeks ago, perhaps, that India locked down the entire country. So that was 1.6 billion people or so with their population. So they were quick to lock it down. Now it says here, also, they're looking to try to build a $650 ventilator. So we'll see about that. Japan considering 6-month period for state of emergency. Now, they were one of the first countries to really start to see some cases. And obviously, that's because of their proximity to China. But for a period of time, they actually had not a lot really going on there. So I kept an eye on it. I was kind of like, oh, what's up with Japan? Why? How are they managing to keep their cases low? But look at here. Short article, just because there's nothing that's definite yet. But it says here, the Japanese government is considering a period of 6 months for the state of emergency that it is preparing to call in response to the coronavirus pandemic, broadcaster TBS reported on Monday. The move would cover Tokyo and three neighboring prefectures, as well as Osaka, TBS said, citing unidentified sources. Within the 6-month period, these prefectures would decide the length of time for their individual measures, TBS said. The government is preparing to announce a state of emergency as early as Tuesday, the broadcaster said. So that tells you, obviously, Japan's taking this thing seriously now. Obviously, they're seeing something in their numbers, a spike in their numbers, that's leading them to think like, hey, we don't want to end up like New York or Italy or Spain or France, for instance. And finally, the last one I've got, which is something contrary to what we've been told in the past. Bronx Zoo Tiger becomes first of its kind to test positive for coronavirus, officials say. They were telling us that animals couldn't test positive. Obviously, we don't know how the tiger contracted the disease, but I remember reading several articles where they were talking about, you know, just the cheesy side of it all, like how pets are so happy that their owners are home more often, staying at home working and whatnot. That's making pets happy because they get to spend more time with their owners. And we were always led to believe that pets couldn't get it at all. Now, that may be true for a lot of species, because if it weren't true, you would think that perhaps we'd see a lot more cases of this, and perhaps we will over time. So what does this mean now? I was watching a video yesterday where they were talking about zoos and how the caretakers, the individuals who work there normally, they're still going to work every day, of course. They're there because the animals have to be fed, their cages still have to be cleaned, they still have to get TLC like they always do, right? And there was all this talk about workers, but never talk about animals, because again, it was felt that animals couldn't contract it, but now we have a case. We'll see if this leads to something larger. But again, with all of these stories, like I said, it's just bad news after bad news, right? It just, whatever aspect of life that you're trying to think of, it just goes to show that with all of these things happening, that there isn't an area, there isn't a person, there isn't a state, country, now even with it going into animals, that there isn't anything that really can't be impacted by all of this. So, like I said in my other video that comes out today, even if you don't take this seriously, even if you think it's all BS, whether where you think it came from, whatever you think its origin is, whether you think it's some conspiracy or not, you know, that's all good. I'm all good. I'm all good with that. You know, I'm not that guy to go call people out over that kind of stuff. But whatever you feel about that in that regard, all I want to say is just take it seriously, at least in the sense of going with the guidelines, right? Staying in your house as much as possible, avoiding contact with other individuals, you know, staying clean, the hand washing, sanitization, all that kind of stuff. If nothing else, just all I can hope is anybody who's watching this video does that. That's all. That's all I hope. So thanks as always for watching my videos, everybody. Take care of yourself, take care of your family and loved ones, and have a good day.